Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at some other UI components that we can add into Scriptcase to kind of add on to its already existing UI components. Today we're going to be looking at popovers and progress bars. Popovers are going to come from the Bootstrap library, and progress bars are going to come from a Pace.js library that we'll look at in a minute. My name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this webinar. So I hope this is helpful for you. Let's go ahead and look at some of the components that we need for popovers. So there's really only three components. We need Bootstrap, we need some HTML and a little bit of JavaScript, and then we can put it in any Scriptcase application. So we're going to look at first how to get Bootstrap and how that works if you're unfamiliar with it. And then we'll go ahead and add it in a couple of Scriptcase applications. So let's get started. All right, so I have here a demo of what our final product is going to look like. And you might notice these green and red elements here, and these are called badges. And there's another video where we discussed how to set those up, so I'd encourage you to go back and listen to those. But we're going to focus on these over here on the right, and these are popovers. So if I mouse over them, a little item pops up and shows some more text, a little bit of more information that might be useful to your users. So that's what we're going to be setting up and developing today. So now let's look at what it takes to get Bootstrap set up. So here's the Bootstrap website. You can go to this at getbootstrap.com. And we need to go to documentation right up here on the top, documentation. Let's click on that. And here's some information about how to set it up inside of your application. So there's some CS and some JavaScript files that you need to include. And there's a starter template here you can use. But let's go to components over here on the left. And that's where we're going to find our information about popovers. And under components, we have badges right there. But down towards the bottom, we also have popovers right here. So let's click that. And here is our page about popovers and how to set that up. So we need a popper.js library included, or popper.min.js. And that's what we need to include to get this set up. And then we have a basic example of the JavaScript needed to actually show a popover. So we just need to call this function that's included with the libraries that we include, and it'll show it. So here's a little demo of how it works with a button. And this is put inside of a button. We're going to put it inside of something else. And we just need that data toggle and some other options here as we want. So here's some different buttons. We can put it in different directions like so. And then down here, we have some options. So these are all the different options that you saw kind of up here that you can pass to it to tell it some different settings. And we're going to be concerned about content and some other things, but content's going to display what's actually in it. Whether or not it displays HTML in the content, that's very useful for us. We're going to use that. And then we also have a title. So that's a title element, a trigger, some other things. So there's lots of different settings here. We're going to use the hover trigger instead of the click trigger. Also some other methods down here that we're not going to worry too much about today. So that's the basics of popovers in Bootstrap. Now let's go to Scriptcase and get this set up in Scriptcase. So here we are in our Scriptcase development environment, and we have this application we already set up for badges called Grid Employees Badges. And we're going to use that today to set up our popovers. So here we have that order count field, and let's run this and see what it looks like. So that's our order field over there that I was just pointing out to you, and that has our badges on it. And then we have some other information along with those badges over there. So it's a pretty simple grid, except for the badges. So now let's go back to Scriptcase and let's add a field for our popover. So we're going to click new field, just one new field. It's going to be a text field, and we're going to name this info like so, and leave the label blank, like so, and let's save that. Now we need to actually assign a value to this. So we're going to leave this where it is. Let's go to the on application init event here. And this is where we set up our Bootstrap libraries here. So we have the different CSS and JavaScript libraries that we need for this. So we set that up in the on application init event. And then on the on record event is where we set up the order count. So we do a query here and then assign some values to the order count field right down here. Now below this, we can set up our popover. So let's add ourselves some lines here. and we need to assign some information that we're going to put in that popover. So we're going to use the notes field that comes out of the database, and this already has some notes about our employees here. So we assign that to a variable, right there, information, and then we're going to use that in our popover. So we're going to assign to our info field that we just created the code for our popover. So we're using the curly braces there to assign a value to it. And let me just copy some code in here. There we go. So this is just some HTML here. We're putting it inside of an H5 tag. So let me show you everything that's inside there. So that's all that code. And then we have an A tag here. So let me tab that over so it's clear what is in there. So in that A tag are the options that we saw on our Bootstrap documentation right here. So those are all those options that we can use. And so the data trigger is going to be the hover, like I mentioned before. We're commenting out the focus line. And then the data toggle is going to be the popover that'll be used for our JavaScript. And we're telling it to display HTML, giving it a title of information. And then in the content, we're putting that variable of our information that we saved from our notes. Then we're setting some colors for the little option that's going to be moused over. We're using a font awesome icon for the information circle, like so. And then we just close up the A tag and close up the H5. And there we have it. There's our code. Now we just need to set up the JavaScript side of this so that it works to actually pop over the text. So I'm going to copy some more code in here. But this is JavaScript code, so we need to close up our PHP block here. And then down below at the bottom, we are opening our PHP block back up so that it can continue processing. And this is just that simple JavaScript using the data toggle to pull the element out and then using the popover function from the library to actually run it. And now we just need to add one more thing. We need to add the actual Bootstrap library here, JavaScript library, just to make sure the scoping is all set up because it's not scoped perfectly right in the on application init. So now everything's set up with our popover. Let's go ahead and run this. And this should work. So it's loading our grid here, and there is our new field. And we mouse over it, and we get the text from our popover. So that's how to set up popovers inside of Scriptcase using the Twitter Bootstrap library. So now we're going to go on and look at how to set up progress bars. So here are the components we need for progress bars in Scriptcase. First, we need the pace.js library, and we'll look at how to get that. And then we'll also use one of the pace themes. Once those are set up, we just need some HTML, some JavaScript, and we can put it in any Scriptcase application, much like the badges in the popovers with the Twitter Bootstrap library. So let's get started with progress bars using pace. So here we are at the pace website. You can find this on GitHub. And if you look here, it tells us that we need the pace.js library right here, and then a CSS theme of our choice, just like that. So what are those themes? Well, they have some examples here. So they have different themes, minimal, flash, barbershop, etc. And these are just different styles of progress bars. So there's lots of different styles here, lots of different options for your website. And then you can also change the color for these. So if you choose color, let's click that and let's choose maybe a green neon color. And then click OK on that. And it's going to reload it and show us here. So that's a pretty nasty green color. But let's change that because that's kind of annoying. Let's take it back to blue. But lots of different colors here. And so now we're back to blue, which looks a little bit nicer. Let's stay with blue for this. So let's scroll down to the bottom here. And to get this, we can click on the documentation or we can go directly to GitHub. But let's click on the documentation to show us some of what we can do with this. Okay, so here's a documentation for pace, and you could scroll through this and see lots of different options. Here we have an example of how it's included, both the JavaScript and the CSS theme. But if we go up to the top here, we have a download zip where we can download the file for the pace library. So let's download that and save it to my computer here. And we're going to put this inside of Scriptcase. So after it downloads, then we can upload it to our Scriptcase development environment. So here we are in our Scriptcase development environment. We've got that file downloaded. And let's put this inside of our external libraries. We're going to go to Tools, External Libraries right here. And I've got a lot of external libraries here. And you see only one of them is included. The rest of them have a button next to it to say use library. So none of those are included by default. We'd have to click that. And then down here, we can create a new library. So let's click that, choose the scope. Let's set that to just the project instead of public. And let's name it. We're just going to name it PC. And then click create. And then if we scroll down here, we should see it as one of our options, but it's not included yet. So let's click use library. It's going to reload the page here, but it's not yet saved. We need to click save project libraries. Otherwise those changes won't be saved. So let's click that. Data saved successfully. Now let's edit our library that we created. So we click the edit button. And here is our empty library. There's nothing here yet. So let's click upload. And let's select our zip that we downloaded from the Paste website. So there it is. Upload that, and then it'll automatically extract it as long as this box is checked right here. So that's very convenient. Click OK. And there it is. There's our folder. We're going to rename that to make it a little bit easier to access. We're just going to call it Paste. So we click the Edit button and then rename it. And then let's go into that folder. So here is all of our files. There's the paste.js files that we need to include. And then in our themes folder is where all those themes are, so we can include those files. So we've got all those different colors. And then if we go into one of them, we've got all the different progress bar styles there. So now let's put this inside of a blank application. So we're going to go to new application here. Wait for that to load, then choose blank application right here. And then let's name it, like so, and let's hit create. So a blank application is just a place to put some code if you don't know what it is. So now we just need to put in some HTML. So we need to close up the PHP block here and then open it up again at the end so it can continue processing. And first we need to include the paste.js library. So here's some code for that. And this is how we do this in Scriptcase. This scurl library is going to take the source and assign it to the correct path for that library in our Scriptcase system. So we don't have to worry about pathing. We can just automatically assign it. And if we go here, there's our paste folder. So we're giving it our paste folder first. And then if we go to our paste folder, there's our paste.js file right there that we're including. So that's just a script tag. And then we've included the paste.js library. Now we need to include the CSS theme of our choice. So I've got one more line of code to copy here. And this is just like assigning a style sheet in an HTML document. We've got that same folder system with the same macro, same library. But now we're going into the themes folder. So that's this folder right here. And then we're telling it which theme we want. So we want blue, and then we want just the basic loading bar theme. So let's run this. This is going to run while the page loads. So that's what this progress bar does, is it loads for the duration of the page load. That's kind of short. So let's make this a little bit longer. So I'm going to add something here. This is an option that Paste gives us, a ghost time option. So this is going to make it appear for a little bit longer. So let's run this. And that way it's a little bit longer, so it's easier for us to see. Now let's experiment with some of these themes. So over here on our CSS themes, we can change the color. So right now it's blue, and we can also change the style of loading bar. So let's go back to our external library and go inside of that themes folder. So here's all the different color options we have. Let's choose orange. So we just need to point it to a different folder. And that exact same loading bar style will be there, just in a different color. So there we go. There's our orange loading bar. And we can also change it to a different style. So that's just this last part of that path. Let's go and look at some of our styles. So if we go into the orange folder here, we've got all these different options here. So let's choose this one here, this barbershop one. So I'm just going to get that name and copy it here. And then I just need to paste it right in place here. So that's going to look a little bit different. Let's load this and see what it looks like. And there we go. That one takes up the whole screen. is a little bit more obnoxious, but perhaps that's something you might want. Let's try another one. Let's choose one of these down here. Let's choose this one. And let me go back and put that in here. And let's run this. Okay, so that one appears up top. It's not quite as obnoxious, so maybe that's something you'd want if it's a little bit quicker, perhaps. So now let's put this back to the way it was. We're going to keep the basic one now, so that we can use this in a grid. So now we just need to take the ghost time out, and we're going to put this in a grid application. So let's take that out, and then we just want to copy all this code. So I'm going to select it all here, and just copy it. And now we're going to go find a grid application to put this in. So in our sample systems, we got lots of different grids here. And I'm just going to find one here. So I'm going to go to root and then grid products right here. You can put this inside of any Scriptcase application. We're going to go to events and then on application init right here. So this is as soon as the page loads, it's going to include this paste library. So let's run this. And this should be a little bit slower now. And there we go. It's showing us how long it takes for the page to load completely for this grid. So that's just a basic implementation of paste inside of your Scriptcase development environment for your own applications. So I hope this was helpful for you, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorials.